active and we can see its activity here at the orbit of Earth where it shakes the magnetic field of Earth, particularly during a storm. But if you go to auroral latitudes, you'll find there's magnetic activity all the time. It never ceases. And that was a clue that somehow was overlooked, because most of the time, the auroral activity is not interesting. It's not doing enough to really excite a storm of any kind. And gradually, one tried to reimagine how magnetic fields can accelerate particles. Well, static magnetic fields cannot accelerate particles. And you tried several ideas, and the field began to clear up and become more interesting with the work of Biermann and Hofmeister, both of whom studied the pointing of comet tails. It's well known, and had been for some time, that comets' tails always point away from the sun, no matter which way they're actually moving. If you look up and you see a comet in the sky, you automatically assume its tail is hanging out behind and it's moving like so. But it isn't. As a matter of fact, what's happening is that the tail is pointing away from the sun as it goes around the sun. And then when the comet is heading away from the sun, the tail is out in front. And that was explained by the radiation pressure of sunlight, until Biermann spoiled the whole thing by doing a calculation. Beware of observations and calculations. And found that the absorption cross-section of a comet, the molecules in a comet, is lacking about a hundredth of what it should be if you're going to use it to push comet tails around. And so they pointed out that the only alternative was solar corpuscular radiation, that is, particles from the sun, is what's responsible for comet tails pointing away from the sun. And again, the important fact there was that comets never show themselves unless they're tail is pointing away from the sun. And that tells you that the solar corpuscular radiation is there all the time, 24/7. And that means it's not an exotic effect. It's an everyday, workaday effect. And that leaves you only one conclusion, that it's hydrodynamics, that the corona is expanding. And that's substantiated by another fact. The corona is clearly static, or nearly so, in the lower corona near the sun, and clearly moving fast out here where it's pushing comet tails. So you have the whole thing laid out for you if you care to notice. And I was motivated to write down the momentum equation for radial expansion, and there's your wind. So it was just fun. I was curious, and after many years of being puzzled, it finally, with the work of Biermann and others, in fact, I owe a debt of gratitude to Ludwig Biermann. He came by the lab one time to visit John Simpson, and I had a chance to talk with him, and he was very helpful and free in discussion, and he had the observations that were the key to the whole thing. That's what really enervated my curiosity. I've been mildly curious before that, but after talking with Biermann, I was passionately curious. So that's